Hello everyone. Welcome to the 9th part of the Adobe After Effects tutorial from beginner to advanced. In this video, I will teach you how to create keyframes. It is better to first know what a keyframe is and then learn how to make it. In animation and filmmaking, a keyframe is a rhombus or shot that defines the start and end point of a smooth transition. Now I create a composition with dimensions 1920x1080 and frame rate of 30. It means that 1 second of 30 frames is created. I consider the duration of the composition to be 2 minutes and press the OK button. I import a video in my channel logo. I drag these two files into the timeline. The logo layer must be the top layer to display the logo on the video. I click on the logo layer and enter the transform section where there are anchor point, position, scale, rotation, and opacity options. We examined these options in previous lessons. Next to each of these options, there is an icon similar to a stopwatch. We use these stopwatches to create keyframes for each of these options. For example, if we want to create a keyframe for position, we click on the stopwatch next to the position option. In front of each of these options, there is a line where keyframes are placed on these lines. First, I make the scale of the logo smaller. Note, since I haven't created any keyframes yet, this rescaling will apply to this layer until the end of the composition. Now I want to create a keyframe for the position option. So now I put the logo outside the image so that we can transfer the logo on the video by creating keyframes. To create a keyframe, we must set the time indicator to the desired or starting time. For example, I want to create a keyframe at 1 second. So, I set the time indicator to 1 second and click on the stopwatch next to the position. In this way, a keyframe is created in the timeline at 1 second and in front of the position option. If you pay attention, now the color of this stopwatch has changed to blue, which shows that a keyframe has been created for the position option. And also a blue key has been created on the left side of the position option. This key is used to remove or add keyframes in the timeline. This key turns blue when the time indicator is placed on the keyframe. Now if I click on the blue key again, the keyframe we created in the timeline will be deleted. I set the time indicator to 2 seconds. I click on the key on the left, so at 2 seconds, another keyframe will be created in the timeline. Now, holding the left click and dragging, I change the position value so that the logo enters the image. So, in this way, the logo enters the picture. Similarly, with the selection tool and holding the left click, it is possible to change the location of the logo too. Hold the shift button along with the left click to make the logo move in a straight line. I change the position of the time indicator again and set it to 4 seconds. I want the logo to stay still from second 2 to second 4 without moving, so I click on this key on the left side of the image. In this way, another keyframe is created in the timeline, and you can see that the logo remains constant from second 2 to second 4. Let's change the opacity of the logo this time. From second 4 to second 6, I change the opacity of the logo from 100 to 0, so that the logo is hidden in the 6th second. So I set the time indicator to the 4th second and click on the stopwatch next to the opacity to create a keyframe. In fact, the changes of the opacity option start from the 4th second. Now I set the time indicator to 6 seconds and set the opacity value to 0. In this way, you can see that the opacity of the logo starts to decrease from second 4 until it is completely hidden at second 6. If you want to move on the previous and next keyframes, you can use these two arrows. To delete all keyframes, you can select them by holding the left click and pressing the delete button from the keyboard. or click on stopwatches. Finally, do not forget these 4 points. First, if you create a keyframe for a position, for example, you don't need to click on this key to create the next keyframe. Just place the time indicator in the desired frame and change the location of the logo with the selection tool. In this way, another keyframe is created automatically. The second point is that you can use Ctrl plus C and Ctrl plus V to copy keyframes. I select and copy both keys and place the time indicator in the desired frame and paste. In this way, keyframes are copied. The third point is to remember that any changes made to the last keyframe will last until the end of the video. You can create keyframes for all layers and all these options. Be sure to practice all these things to learn how to work with keyframes well. In the following tutorials, we will use keyframes a lot. Please like the video and leave a comment for me. Subscribe to see more tutorials. I'll see you next time.